My indoor session today was on the Elite Drivo, one of the top of the range direct drive smart trainers to choose from in the market today. Known for its killer power accuracy, pretty low noise, and a pretty good ride feel as well. So what I was looking at today after my session was the pedal stroke analysis, or the pedaling analysis they call it. Now this is the peanut. If everyone is familiar with the pedal stroke peanut, a lot of trainer companies are adding this as a value add to their existing trainers. Or if you've got a power meter, a lot of power meter companies are coming out with these pedaling metrics, Garmin being one of them. Rota also have it, PowerTap have it, like they're all doing it. So what is it all about on the Elite side of things? Let's have a dive into it today. So the three trainers from Elite that support this at the moment are the Elite Drivo, what we've got here, the Kura, which is the Drivo's smaller brother, but the same optical torque sensor for power measuring, and also the Direto smart trainer that was just recently out. With the Drivo and the Kura, there's 24 points throughout the pedal stroke measured, and it can go up to 150 RPM. The Direto is only 12 points. So you are at a lower price point with the Direto, 12 points of measurement throughout the pedal stroke. The pedal stroke analysis option is part of MyETraining on Windows, Mac, Android, and iOS. So they've got it covered across the board. So the information sheet here we have shows the optical torque sensor. That's what measures the power. Highly accurate, 1%. Okay, the pedaling analysis, just explaining what it's all about there. And you can see there on the sheet, it says the Drivo has 24 points around the circle of power measurement or position measurement, I think you'd call it. An interesting problem to tackle with pedal stroke analysis measured further down the drivetrain, well, specifically on a smart trainer, is which is left and which is right. All it sees is the chain pulling, so it doesn't know left or right. Elite solved that problem with a plug-in cadence sensor. There's a little extra plug next to the power port. I'll flip that up here. But not only that, you can put in the angle this is on as well for absolute killer accuracy. I'm not going to go that deep today into this data. I just want to see the peanut and how smooth my pedal stroke is. But there's the answer to how they figure out what's left and what's right measuring pedal stroke analysis down the drivetrain. So a few options they have to display the pedal stroke. Nearly every company does it a little bit differently. So we have what they call a Cartesian graph here. And we can have either the current pedal stroke shown, the last two, or the last three. We'll go through that in a sec. It's pretty cool. We can then go to the standard peanut. That's probably the most useful one for me to see if I'm balanced. But there's a gotcha with the peanut as well, with left and right. It's a little kind of wonky, but that's how the peanut always is across the board. That's probably the most useful one. So we can go to the peanut, or we've just got an informational screen there that tells you how efficient your pedal stroke is. Pedal strokes are always almost sine waves. So you're never gonna get, as it says here, you're never gonna reach 100%. Close to 65 is considered very good. And there's the summary screen. There's a few customizable things you can put up. Scrolling down, and the last page there is how to install that with the correct angles. If you're hardcore into it, I'll link below to this information of how to install that to get it absolutely spot on. But today, I just want to have a look at what it's all about and how smooth my pedal stroke is. Okay, enough of what it's all about. Let's jump on the bike. Let's ride. Alrighty, loading up MyETraining here for Windows. We have the configuration settings here. Let's just go through that. So I'm on the Drivo, making sure that's okay. Okay, it's picked up the Drivo. Proceed, wheel circumference sticking with defaults. No other sensors hooked up. Back to dashboard, and there we go. Oh, just one thing of note as well, a subscription to MyETraining is a yearly subscription, which is a few dollars, and the pedaling analysis is a few more dollars on top of that. So that's why it's available. I've got my subscription enabled on here, so I can just click it straight away. Pedaling analysis, here we go. Everything on the screen here. The informational sheet we ran through earlier in the video was from the mobile application. What I'll show today, though, is the Windows application, because it has it all on the screen at once. So what we've got here is the configuration options. Number of pedal strokes to show, just the one for now. We have some minimum resistance set, chart offset, a few other things there, but we're just looking at the basic overview today. So we'll hit save on that. We'll go with defaults, it's on level one, and away we go. Okay, straight away, we have the Cartesian graph shown, we have the peanut shown, and we've got all the other values on screen. minimum power, current power, maximum power, speed, uniformity. So it's all there on this one screen. That's pretty cool. So the Cartesian graph part first. Let me apply a little bit more resistance to the unit. Actually, we can up it with a level as well. Let's go level 3. Okay. And you can see there those two peaks. Definitely not uniform. And if I go one side over the other, to one side and then the other, that grows. So over to the peanut itself. And what you can see there, the part where the peanut squeezes together in the center, they're your dead spots. So if I was very smooth throughout the whole pedal stroke, that'll be very circular. There we go, taking out all the dead spots. So that's pedaling in circles. Whether that's most efficient, I don't think so. But if we go back to standard cycling where you have a few dead spots there, you can see the peanut take full effect. Now peanuts will always be a little wonky, that's just how it's displayed. The right side will always be a little higher and the left side a little lower in the full 360. So that's normal, you'll never really have a horizontal peanut. But again, left and right on that. So go harder on the right. Harder on the left, it just throws it all out of whack. There we go. Now the angle on these, as I've said before, will be spot on if you use the cadence sensor and hook everything up. But we're just going for the, what is it all about today? Okay, the next one's the uniformity. Let's have a look at that. Now they said 65, 64 was pretty good. Let's see what we can get to. Can't even nudge over 60. So they're the defaults of that. I'm going to exit that and we'll go to settings and we'll show 3 pedal strokes on here. Probably a little more valuable. And it goes red, not so reddish pink to show it fading away. Okay, we'll have enabled that in the settings. Hit play again. And once I have 3 pedal strokes, it will display them on the screen and fade them away. Ah, right. Okay, that's probably more valuable to me. Again, I'll go choppy on the pedal stroke and that peanut will really die in the middle on the dead spots. And if I go super smooth, you can see that peanut expand out, so removing the dead spots. So that's what that's all about, and it works pretty well. That's on the Drivo. The Kura has exactly the same OTS torque sensor, will show exactly the same information, and the Direto has a 12-point analysis as well of that. Now, let's reduce some levels. And let's see how smooth we can get by having a bit of fun. So just arm cranking this around, can I apply a perfect circle? And you can see there, that's the difference between pedal stroke with obviously a leg and an arm. That gives a really good indication of what that dead spot actually is. It's right in the center as you bring the pedal over top, 12 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and up from the bottom. Very cool. So training wise, is this useful? Well, staring at a screen like this, maybe not. It will get you nice and zen and smooth, but it's not really that entertaining. It's just chasing some numbers on the screen. The value that I see in pedal stroke analysis like this is to use it in conjunction with whatever software you choose to use. So you'll have your speed, cadence, heart rate, you'll have power. That's the number, the result of what you're doing. This will show you how you're generating that power. Are you choppy? Are you smooth? Are you going up a hill and doing a big strength effort, nice and smooth? Are you high spinning? That watt number doesn't really show you how you're doing that number. This can sort of give you an insight into that, which is pretty cool. And I think that's where this will start heading in the future with applications including this in-game or in-program, I guess you'd call it. Let me see what I can whip up here on the screen so we can have this showing and Zwift at the same time. So here's one example of how you could do it. I've got two ant sticks in the machine. I have Zwift loaded up and paired to the unit as a smart trainer, so it does have control of the trainer. And it appears that the pedal stroke analysis is working perfectly in the background. Let me just put a bit more pressure on the pedals. There we go, okay, it's coming back into its own now once I've started upping the watts a little bit. So there we have it. That's how I would use this for training if I was to be using that pedal stroke analysis in game. So you'd have Zwift up, you'd have a workout running or a group ride or whatever you're doing, just maybe just riding along. But you also have that pedal stroke analysis on screen showing what's going on. So for long steady state intervals to keep you in that zone and efficiently in that zone, you can see there I'm a little bit wonky while I'm talking here. So if I sort of get down and concentrate, things get a little bit smoother. Or on Zwift, if I spin around, you can see pedaling a little labor there. If I spin around on Zwift, there we go. Let's go with the resistance. That changes my pedal stroke profile as I'm going down the hill there. So the pedal stroke analysis itself is interesting, but not really that useful. Put it in context like this, it's a brilliant value add. I would love to see this integrated into all software, maybe even as an overlay option. Before I wrap this one up, I've got another idea for the overlay on the screen here, which I think will be a little better. Okay, let me tinker. We'll see what we can come up with. So just as a proof of concept, I've snuck in the mobile app as an overlay there in the top left-hand corner next to the power number here on Zwift. So you've got the power number there, you've got all your details and metrics, but you've got how you're generating that power right next to it. That's pretty cool. I'm totally choppy now, but if I smooth that out, you can see that 80 watts, 93 watts, etc. is being generated and how it's being generated. There we go. I'm a bit wonky with left and right, but we can actually switch that as well over to the peanut. And we can have an on-screen peanut to see what's going on. Now that's the value add that I'd love to see in game. Maybe have it optional so you can turn it on or off, but you can see how your power's being generated. Okay, we'll leave it there for today. So there's the overview of the pedal stroke analysis or pedaling analysis on the Elite Trainers and what's possible and what may be possible. I think that peanut's pretty cool on screen at the same time. Okay, thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.